I got Chris and PJ here live in the Dream Giveaway
Hello,
Garage.
Everybody. We're laughing here because of what Chris just said a minute ago.
That's right. Well, welcome. It's Thursday, and Roger asked yesterday if we found the speakers and the sound system in the Restomod Corvette, the grand prize in the 2024 Classic Corvette Dream Giveaway. And yes, we have. I'm going to show you where the speakers are located first. But before I do, let me tell you, it's very stealth. They did such a fantastic job. And there's not a receiver with knobs and dials and a tuning bar. Everything is hidden, so you got to know how to use it, and it's really nice. But first, we'll tell you that so far I have found three speakers, but I think that there's a subwoofer hiding. So if you fold these wonderful Italian leather seats forward, you can see that triaxle speaker right there. Triaxle means there's one driver here, a second driver here, and a second driver here. That's bass, that's mid-range, and that's tweeter. And there's, PJ, can you move that seat as well? Oh, we have the car cover there.
Car cover's in the way.
PJ will move that, and you can see. So it's there.
So it's behind both seats.
Behind both seats. But that's not the only place. You can put that back there, PJ. It's okay. There's also, in the stock location, there's a speaker up here as well.
So okay, but there's no radio controls.
There's no radio controls anywhere in the cabin. So here's how it works. So we're so excited. We've had Burt Reynolds help us in the past. And this time, there's Burt. We're going to have Frank Sinatra help us today.
Okay, so this is kind of a different fire it up, right?
Yeah, we're going to fire up Frank. And there, you see that, the blue and the red there? That means that it is paired by Bluetooth to my iPhone. And
or anybody who gets in it.
Right. And so I control both the content as well as the volume from an app. So I'm going to do that right now for you guys.
And it doesn't really matter what app, whether you're on your, you could be in your phone app.
It could be YouTube, it could be iTunes.
Right. It could be
I happen to be using Cobuz, which has high-res audio. And so let's do this, and let's see if Frank comes on board. There we go. All from my phone, no radio control.
Fly me to the moon. Let me play among the stars.
It's like one big speaker.
Let me see what spring is like on Jupiter and Mars. In other words, hold my hand.
It's got quite the bass.
It has quite the bass, plus the speaker up there. This is so cool. Again, this is the technology in this Restomod from front to rear, even includes audio. I think the Dream Giveaway Garage team are going to come out and start showing off their Mamba moves, right?
That's right. Well, we don't want to get a content violation here, so let's...
So I'm turning down Frank. Frank, thank you for helping us today. We appreciate you. And then I'm going to power down, turn off the key there. So all of this is controlled by a Bluetooth app, Bluetooth and whatever app you'd like on your phone, whether it's an iPhone or an Android.
Boy, they didn't have that 50 years ago.
Definitely didn't have that 50 years ago, right? Which reminds me, you guys remember way back in the 50s and the 60s, I've seen them, you could get a record player.
In a car?
In a car. You could get a record player. And don't ask me how that could possibly work, because you need that needle to not bounce around, right? So how would you do that unless your shocks are ultra, ultra smooth? I've seen a turntable in a Ford product and some other custom vehicles from the 1960s. But this is a whole new level of enjoying audio.
Larry West says, so what happens when a phone call comes in? And I'm just like any other call. It can be transferred to your phone, or you can just be on speaker in your call,
That's
your car.
Correct. Yeah, you could take a call the same way. I haven't found the microphone, if there's a microphone in the vehicle yet, so we're going to work on that and try to figure that out.
Roger, I wanted to know if there was any USB ports in the lighter position.
There is, and I'd like to show you that as well. So, look down where the... where the cigarette lighter used to be, yeah, or where the ashtray used to be, right?
Right there, two USB ports right there.
Two USB ports right there. USB-A to get technical on you, Roger.
That's right, not C, not C. Let's see here, Larry says, I love the new rims.
Yeah, so do we. Again, the reason we chose them is that it gave the flavor of the classic turbine knockoff wheel that came on the 65 Corvette. But a modern sort of interpretation of that, and much safer than the original knockoff turbine wheels, of course. Let's take a look at that engine again, because it is super duper.
While you're in there, we've got to know, is there anything in the console?
There's not. There's a cup holder.
A cup holder.
There's one cup holder. You can lift the top piece of leather off, kind of, well,
does the whole thing come
up? You got to hold that. Go ahead, PJ. There you go.
Oh, look at that.
Look at that.
And even the cover even has that cup holder.
And
whoops.
Let me pop that hood.
All right, so Chris popped the hood here. We'll put that on here.
Very classy Corvette.
Ooh.
And look at that, guys. And ladies, look at that. LS3, 495 horsepower with... What is a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 on PJ's favorite white shifter knob?
5-speed manual.
There you go. Plus, you see it's got a serpentine belt system happening up front. It's got a Wildwood brakes. It has, what else does it have? Oh, vintage air.
Yep, yeah. Vintage air.
And of course, LS3, non-carbureted, everything fuel injected. What a fantastic vehicle this is. And it is a grand prize in our latest classic Corvette thing giveaway. Right, PJ?
That's right. This one is a sole giveaway.
Yes.
Just one incredible car.
Yeah.
Who doesn't love this complete Restomod? And we were asking quite a few people in some of the videos, and everybody really loves this Restomod.
Everybody loves this Restomod. We picked a really, really good one this time. And whoever built this car, you really got to show them some respect.
Alan says, what color is the hardtop? Because we do have a hardtop for this.
The hardtop is red.
And the hardtop is the same color red, yeah.
The soft top, and we showed it to you yesterday,
it's
is
in
the
this same color, right?
Yeah, same tan color. We're matching, complementary tan color. And I love it. And you can feel the, I mean, this is not cheap leather. This is not pleather. Right? It is not leather red. It is genuine, fine grade Italian hand stitched.
Oh, the stitching
leather
on this is amazing.
It is good stuff. And I saw the receipts for this leather and the interior work, and it was not a bargain price. Someone paid good money to have that interior installed. PJ.
TJ says Napa leather.
I don't know if it's technically Napa leather. I suppose it could be, right?
Yep.
So there you go. PJ, we're going to talk about the NHRA giveaway. You guys might not have seen this because we don't talk about it every day. There's not a car here in the garage. But you can win a trip to the U.S. Nationals. The U.S. Nationals that happens every summer in Indianapolis at the drag strip that's been going on since, what, the late 1950s? And you can win an all-expense-paid trip there, you and a guest.
Yeah, it's one of our lifestyle giveaways that we have on the web.
That's right. And PJ, you helped put that trip package together. Why don't you tell everybody about it?
NHRA.
NHRA, good. So they wanted us to send some people on up there. So that means air flight will be covered, hotel will be covered, and a VIP package at the Drag Racing Nationals there. And you never know. Yeah, Leah Pruitt might show up and say hi to you. Don Garlitz might be there and say hi to you. So remember, that's on the blue tab on dreamgiveaway.com. Look for lifestyle, and then you'll see NHRA.
And it's for 2024, right?
No.
Is it for 2023?
You're thinking Montana.
Oh, that's right.
Yeah, correct. No, that's this August, I believe, the Nationals are. So be sure to get your entries to win that. And while we're talking about trips, if you like trips and you like big trucks and you like big belt buckles, well,
that's right.
And our big diesel truck dream giveaway is for you, because the grand prize not only includes that Ram 3500 that you can't see, but I can see way over there, but a trip to the PBR. Anybody know what that is? Professional bull riding, right?
That's right.
And that's going to happen in Las Vegas.
Vegas
in December in 2024. And the winner is going to get the truck. We're going to pay the taxes. They'll get some fine jewelry from Montana silversmiths. And they're going to get a trip to Las Vegas for the PBR Nationals, right?
Yeah, that big rodeo. That's fantastic.
Big rodeo. Ever been to a rodeo, PJ?
Yes, and that wouldn't be my first.
Have you ever professionally ridden on a bull?
No, PJ? No. No. But I have been out to the PBR.
You have been out to the PBR. There you go. So be sure to know, be sure to get your entries for that big diesel truck and for the NHRA. And what's ending on Tuesday coming up, PJ?
Our Hellcat.
Hellcat, that's right.
That's right.
You only have until Tuesday at midnight Pacific Daylight Time to get your entries to win the Hellcat that Don Garlitz drove down the quarter mile at this year's Gator Nationals.
That's right. And he signed a beautiful helmet along with Leah Pruitt.
Yep.
So the winner gets that as well.
That's correct. So
maybe an awards ceremony we can get Don down here as well.
I think that we'll be able to. Maybe he'll have a Sharpie on him and he'll autograph the car for the winner.
That's right.
Right? He did that for the Charger that we gave away. Where did he autograph that? Underneath the pop open the hood, on the underside of the hood? He did it somewhere in the engine bay.
Yeah, that's right.
Yeah. And that was cool as well. PJ, who's watching? What's going on?
Alan wants to know on this Restomod, and I think you mentioned it earlier, but what is the horsepower of this LS3?
495.
495.
Yep.
Nothing like 50 years ago, Chris.
No. And so in 1965, what's the biggest horsepower that you can get? Maybe a 396, 425 horse, right?
Right.
So this has a more compact engine, a whole lot more technology on it, and even more horsepower. Cool. Who else is out there?
Eric says, let's see the headlamps swivel. We'll have to, when we fire this up.
Okay.
All right, Chris is going to fire it up. Or can you
No, I don't have to fire it up.
Okay, you can just be in aux mode.
All right, let's see here.
Put that one in.
Are they moving?
They're up. One of them actually is down a little bit, so we'll have to look at that.
Okay.
It's crazy.
Okay, they back down?
Yep.
There you go. Is one being a slowpoke, PJ?
Yeah, one is kind of slow there.
Maybe, no worries. All right. Well, that's good. What else do you guys want to see while we're hanging out with the rest of my... Did I ever tell you that it has cruise control? I know I told you that.
Chris has been to Rodeo Drive in California.
There you go, Beverly Hills, old stomping grounds.
Good play on word there,
yeah.
Alan.
Yeah, absolutely. You don't see a whole lot of lifted trucks going down.
No, not there.
Rodeo Drive. That's another story for another day. However, let me tell you this on this car. Because I love them so much, I'm going to show you. I showed them yesterday. I'm going to show them again.
The
gauges.
The gauges.
I love the gauges.
I know. Look at all that.
I really, really like those gauges. And here you can see the Bluetooth trying to pair.
Yep.
To my phone, and that's cool as well. But PJ, look at that. That's something for you. White shifter knob, the USB ports for Roger. That's nice. This plate here, it's very much the same sort of font and style as the original four-speed shift pattern.
Beautiful.
So cool. Okay, I'm going to get out of this, or you're going to have to pry me out, PJ.
Mm-hmm. You'll have to take your music box somewhere else.
Okay, Frank and I are leaving.
Now, Chris, you're a very affluent person when it comes to music and the way stereo systems are,
yes.
And you're a very big audiophile.
Right.
Would you take this setup right here with the car? Or would you take up that setup that you have, that incredible setup that you have at your house with incredible?
There's no comparison. The one in my house.
So this even car can't even compete with your speaker system, right?
Maybe price range it can.
That's right.
Yeah, no, my two-channel system at home is reference level. This is nice for cruising around, but If you're an audiophile, you'll know what I mean. There's nothing like a two-channel reference system.
What were the gauges? What company made those gauges again? You know?
Great question. Dakota Digital, and the line is called the RetroTech.
RetroTech line and
RetroTech Dakota Digital? Line from Dakota Digital, specifically for the Corvette, of course. And what a wonderful set that is.
TJ says, does it have trunk space?
No.
No trunk space.
No. No. And if you think about it, the space behind the seats, the convertible top is there.
Right, yeah, you got this big, huge area for the convertible top.
And you guys, there's not even an area back here. You know what we have. We have the gas tank. So, no, there's really no trunk space. And there's no frunk like the 57.
That's right. You have to travel light when you're driving in this thing.
There you go. But you don't have to drive quietly because you've got that really neat sound system in there. What a cool car. How do you enter to win? I'm glad that someone asked me.
That's right.
Go to dreamgiveaway.com, use promo code Facebook Live or promo code YouTube. Get those bonus tickets. This one just started, so you got plenty of time to get your tickets. Hellcat, though, ends on Tuesday, so you have to get those by end of the day on Tuesday. Tundra ends coming up in 3 weeks, 21 days, I believe.
That's right.
And then NHRA in less than 40 days. I'll tell you which ones now need your loving. Oldsmobile, get some entries to win that 442 W30 car, that factory drag racer. If you are a regular on this channel, you'll know that we met the original owner, told you all about ordering it as an engineer at the famous Milford Proving Grounds. And what do you got, PJ?
Mike Brown is pinging us with a question that you might be seeing on Facebook. It says in the live feed, it says send 200 stars to pin your comment here. I'm not sure what that means as well. So maybe we'll have to have Kathy look into that and find
Kathy
out what that
is. Kathy, look into that and let everybody know what that is, please and thank you. All right, guys. PJ is out tomorrow.
The Hulls wants to know before we go anywhere, though, when will we see the Mach-E in a live video? Well, it definitely won't be a fire it up.
You want to walk over there and end the video
Yeah,
there?
Yeah, we'll take a
Let's
look.
Do that.
And while we're there, Alan wants to know, can we see the Bronco?
Yes.
Yeah, Hold we're
on.
Right there.
I've got lights on.
Oh, you got lights on.
I'm going to make sure I'm not draining the battery.
And there they go.
There you go.
Just like that.
All right.
And of course,
well, PJ,
we've got
you got something top secret you can't show, at least for another week or so. You
well,
want to walk
go.
That
yeah,
way?
I'll go this way.
Okay.
So with this way here, we can get around here, the Mach-E and the Bronco.
Well, luckily, they're right next to each other.
That's right.
So we're back here on Stage A. This is where next Friday at noon, we're going to be handing over the keys to Black Fury 64 Corvette Stingray. And here's the Mach-E, almost 500 horsepower.
And it's right next to that flow charger that we have right behind
right
it.
Right next to the flow charger behind it. We've shown how that works.
I think we've
before.
Actually parked it here for that reason, right? So there's the flow charger
right
there. So it can be
and that's
charged
where you,
up at
that's
any
where
point
you plug in,
time.
In the charger.
Right there in the front.
Yeah. There you go. Great interior on that. Great navigation screen.
And while we're here, we'll look at the Bronco as well.
And the Bronco as well, Wild Track Edition.
Get a little quick shot inside here. Force Customs did some of this stuff.
Yeah. And what I love the Easter egg over here. It says, Bronco established 1966. Right?
Beautiful.
That's so cool. Cactus Gray is the color on this one. And, Space Gray Metallic, I believe, on the Mach-E. So there you go.
You think you'll ever get to a spot? Eric wants to know if you'll be able to squeal the tires on the Mach-E.
Well, I don't think you can. I think that the computer won't let you squeal the tires. But here's the thing. With all that instant torque on it, you'll beat everybody in town right off the green light, right?
That's right.
It is so quick. 469 horsepower. Pretty substantial.
Raymond wants to know, does the Mach-E come with a charger?
Yes. Yeah, it'll come with the flow charger.
And on the Bronco, is this a 2.3 or a 2.7? Eric wants to know.
Oh, 2.7.
Yeah, is it right on the side?
Is it? Pretty sure. Pretty sure I'm right on that one. Look at that. It's not right on the side. You've got the Wildtrak decal right here. But there is not a shout out saying 2.7 EcoBoost. But no, it is the larger of the two engines. Well, guys, thanks for joining us today. We will not be doing a video tomorrow, but we will again on Monday. PJ is planning for being out at the racetrack on Saturday, so he'll be out of office tomorrow. PJ, we're going to miss you tomorrow.
I know. We're going to have a fun time at the track, though.
Yeah, well, are you going to shoot some? Maybe you'll do a Facebook Live on Saturday
night. Yeah, absolutely. We'll do a Saturday night from the racetrack.
There you go. All right, guys. We will see you then on Saturday. PJ will see you on Saturday. PJ and I will see you on Monday with more great fun, more great action, more great grand prizes. It only happens here in our favorite place on Earth, the Dream Giveaway Garage.
See you next time, everyone. Thanks for watching.